I'm inspired by the fact that they're normal kids. They're running around the rooms laughing. They've got friends and sports and social activities.
The things that we can do positively in the life of a young person can influence them for the rest of their life.
The overwhelming majority of our patients lead very healthy, very, really normal lives.
There's probably in the range of somewhere in one in every 2,000 births when you look at craniofacial anomalies. They're basically deformities involving the facial structures or the cranial structures of both. And by that we mean the skull, the brain, the eye sockets, the nose, the upper jaw, the lower jaw, the mouth, and in the ears and the hearing apparatus. So it can be an involvement of any of those or all of those. You're talking about several hundred distinct craniofacial syndromes. There's 10 or 15 that are the most common of those that we see, like craniosynostosis, hemifacial, microsomia, and so forth. They go from more mild to more severe along that spectrum. And these are fairly rare disorders. So in order to get experience in one type of disorder, you have to see a large number of patients over a number of years.
We see 40 to 50 new kids with craniosynostosis a year, 10 to 12 kids per year with the new diagnosis of hemifacial microsomia, 200 to 300 kids a year in the craniofacial team. And so when someone comes to see me or one of my colleagues, they're getting somebody who's doing this day in and day out.
Well, many of these children are diagnosed at birth or soon after, based on their parents. It's important that the baby get expert care immediately. Some children with craniofacial conditions have airway problems, which may cause trouble breathing. Some have other medical issues. CHOP has a specialized team to care for these babies in our neonatal intensive care unit, including some of the best pediatric ear, nose, and throat specialists in the world. It's also important to note that a growing number of craniofacial patients are diagnosed before birth.
We are seeing more and more patients prenatally. Once they receive a diagnosis, then we get involved.
It's always coming off the experience of their ultrasound and wanting to figure out if it's a boy or if it's a girl. That initial hope, excitement, and joy then gets replaced with anxiety and fear about the future for their unborn child.
Meeting families prenatally really helps educate them and helps them understand so that when we meet them after delivery, they are a little better prepared.
That's very exciting.
The Garbos Family Special Delivery Unit is a labor and delivery suite that is specifically dedicated to caring for pregnant women, carrying fetuses with malformations.
Patients have immediate access to all the specialists they may need. That care is right there as soon as the baby's delivered.